gentlemen, welcome. To celebrate the 50th anniversary of the International Society for Krishna Consciousness, the founder of charity, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, the Bhaktivedanta Players present Jai Prabhupada, every town and village.
Swamiji, you want to go like all the other Swamis for sightseeing?
Here, America is a very big country, very great country. Big, big buildings, big, big cars.
No, Jokshiji. I have no interest in sightseeing. My only business is to go there and preach, to speak about Krishna.
That is very impressive, Swamiji. Please excuse me. To go to America, you will need so many papers. You will need passport, you will need sponsorship letter, visa. Do you have all these things?
Chokshiji, please look. These are the papers I have.
Let me see. Oh, you are having.
So now kindly, you ask Sumati Muraji to give me one ticket.
Okay, I will certainly ask her. You please Come and sit. Come and take a seat.
Thank you, Chokshiji. Hare Krishna, Hare.
Chokshiji! Chokshiji, where are you?
I have to go, Swamiji.
Yes, Mr. Moraji?
Why this order has not been pushed through?
Well, we're only waiting for your final endorsement. Everything is in place. Everything is done.
Well, everything seems in order. Good.
Srimati Moraji, Swami Bhaktivedanta from Vrindavan is here. He wants to see you.
For what reason is he here? Does he want another donation for his books?
No, actually no. He has come to ask for a ticket to America. He wants to go on one of your cargo ships.
Swamiji, America? No, that is not possible. He is too old. What does he want to go there for? What he will accomplish there? No. Better he stays here and completes his translation work.
But he seems very...
No, Chokshiji. You tell him I said no.
He will be very disappointed.
If he dies there, it will be on my head only. Go tell him I said no.
Yes. Yes, madam. Yes, I will do.
Ah, Chokshiji, do you have any good news for me?
Unfortunately, Swamiji, Srimati Moraji has refused. I'm very sorry.
You must be insistent with her. This is very important work I have to do in America.
But she will just say no.
Please, you ask her again. I must fulfill the order of my Guru Maharaj.
Yes. Okay, Swamiji. You sit. I will try. I will try one more time.
Thank you. Hare Krishna.
So, he is gone now?
No. He will not take no for an answer. Actually, if I may say, madam, I find this Swamiji is very genuine and sincere man. Imagine, Swamiji will go to America. He will tell the Americans about Krishna. That will be so wonderful.
Stop your dreaming, Chokshiji. The journey will be too difficult for an old man like him. He will not survive. Then what of his plans? Who will even listen to him? It is a foreign place, very different to our India. The winters in New York are bitterly cold. What will he even accomplish there? Nothing whatsoever. No. Tell him I said sorry, no.
Yes, I will, madam.
So, has she agreed?
I'm afraid not, Swamiji. She's insistent that this will not be good for your health.
Then I will have to speak to her personally.
No. She is very busy, lady. She's busy.
I must see her.
Swamiji, please.
I must see her. Ah, Sumati Moraji. It is so nice to see you again.
Oh, Swamiji, what is it that you want from me?
Please, I require one ticket to America.
No, Swamiji, with due respect, you are too old. You will not survive the journey in a cargo ship.
No. I am very healthy. Krishna, he will protect me.
But why do you want to go
worry.
There?
Not worry at all.
It is a dangerous and cold place. There is no culture there, Swamiji. Stay in India and complete your translating work. I like your book very much.
My Guru Maharaj, he has ordered me to go and tell the people of the West about Krishna. I simply want to fulfill his order. My time on this planet is very limited. So please, I kindly ask you, help me, one ticket to America.
You are a very persistent man, Swamiji.
Yeah, I must be persistent. This message is most important.
Oh, I don't know what to do. Oh, this is completely against my better judgment. It will be on my head should anything happen to you, Swamiji. But very well, I will do it.
Ah, Jai, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
I will make arrangements for you on one of our ships. I will take care of everything for you.
Thank you very much, Sumati Muraji. Krishna will be very pleased with you.
Now you get your papers in order. Complete this P form. Once that is done, tell Mr. Chokshiji and he'll make the necessary arrangements for you.
In order to do this, I will need to stay in Bombay. But I have nowhere to live.
You don't worry for that. Mr. Chokshiji will make arrangements for you to stay in our Scindia colony until all the paperwork is complete.
Thank you for your kindness. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
But one thing, in the evenings, I want you to come to my place and read Srimad Bhagavatam to us.
That will be my pleasure. Thank you, Hare Krishna.
Jai Shri Krishna.
Jai Shri Krishna.
Oh, very good, very good. So, Swamiji, tomorrow I will take you shopping and we will buy some warm clothes. You know, you will need warm clothes in America, also on the ship. That is my seva for you.
Danyavad, Chokshiji, danyavad. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Thank you.
Ah, Swamiji, I have noticed you have been coming here from time to time for many, many years. I see you chant very quietly in the back of the temple. Often I notice there are tears in your eyes when you chant Hare Krishna with such sincerity. You then just give a donation and leave. Every now and then, you return and do the same thing. The last time I saw, you were wearing the clothes of a married person. And you never spoke. You would just keep yourself to yourself. And then all of a sudden, you stopped coming. And I did not see you again for many, many years until today. But not as a married person, but a person wearing the clothes of a sannyasi. Who are you? Who is chanting so sincerely and crying? And Swamiji, what does this place mean to you?
I am the lowly disciple of His Divine Grace, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Maharaj Prabhupada, founder of Gaudiya Math. My name is Ubhayacharanaravindam Bhakti Vedanta Swami. My Guru Maharaj has ordered me to preach Krishna consciousness to the Western speaking people of the world. Tomorrow I set sail to America from Kolkata.
Ah, Swami, that is amazing. Wonderful, wonderful.
I have just visited my Guru Maharaj's Samadhi in Mayapur to seek his blessings. And now I have to come to this holy place of Advaita Acharya's house. It was in this actual room 500 years ago that Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu, along with their associates, would discuss the spreading of Sankirtan movement in every town and village of this world. It was Mahaprabhu's desire. He wanted it. In fact, he predicted it. It would happen now, and I feel the weight of the burden of his mission on my shoulders. Hence, I seek their support and blessings to carry out this great order that has been given to me. This place is surcharged with their presence.
But Swamiji, why did you stop coming for so long?
As a family man, I got very much caught up in my household duties, which gave me little time to come here. But now, in my old age, I have come to pray for the strength to fulfill my mission.
Ah, Swamiji, I wish you well. Even though it seems impossible for the foreigners and Malechas to take to Mahaprabhu's mission, their way of life is so different.
It is up to him. I am but an instrument in his will. Hare Krishna, Hare
Krishna. Hare Krishna, Swamiji. Here, take some Mahaprasadam.
My son, are all the trunks secure on the ship?
Yes, father. They're all on the ship now.
These trunks are most important, for they carry the books which I have labored so hard to translate into English. But sweat and blood has gone to produce the first volume of Srimad Bhagavatam.
More of your books will be loaded in Cochin. Oh, father, is this also necessary? Just see how old you are. Going to a foreign place, you will be all alone. No support, no disciples, no money, no proper accommodation anywhere.
Vrindavan. I always have the presence of my Guru Maharaj with me all the time.
Oh, I worry about the journey on the ship. 3 weeks with no proper accommodation or food. This is a freight ship, not designed for passengers.
Vrindavan, I have everything I need. My beads to chant Hare Krishna. And my Chaitanya Charitam gives me immense happiness.
Oh, I wish you would reconsider and not go.
No, no, no. I have made up my mind. I must go. This was the desire of Thakur Bhaktivedanta. He wanted Krishna consciousness to go to the West.
Very well. Well, I checked your cabin. It is quite comfortable. And Captain Bundy has assured me he has put extra vegetables and fruits just for you. If you need anything, please ask him. Don't hesitate. I think he will be here coming really soon.
Vrindavan, do not worry about Krishna. We'll take care of you. I will stay in touch with you all the time.
Swamiji, welcome aboard the Jaladuta ship. I will try and make your travels as comfortable as possible. It is such an honor to have you travel.
Captain Pandya, here are a set of my books for you to read on the journey.
Oh, that is very kind. How much?
You can simply give a donation for my course.
I give would be hardly anything. You will need more if you are going to survive in Europe. It is so expensive to give this money to you.
Captain Pandya, Krishna is the richest. Everything belongs to him. So if he wants to give, what is the problem?
You have such conviction, Swamiji. This, come, let me show you to your gentleman.
Vrindavan, I do not want you to stay here anymore. You please go home now. You will get very emotional. Krishna, he will take care of me. Here.
40 rupees for you. This is all I have. Do not worry. I will stay in touch with you. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Father. Goodbye. Keep in touch. And please, write regularly. We want to know how you are doing.
I will be there. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
This way, Swamiji. Please, mind your step. Ah, here we are. You can keep your belongings here. You have a nice view of the sea. And you can cook here. I will try and make your stay as comfortable as possible. Now, you must excuse me, as I have to make arrangements for leaving. Swamiji, I will see you soon.
Captain Pandya. Thank you very much for your kind hospitality. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. I will write a diary of my journey on the Jaladuta. August 13, 1965. The cabin is quite comfortable. Thanks to Lord Krishna for inspiring Sumati Muraji to make these arrangements. I am quite comfortable. Hare Krishna. Deep focus. Today I feel seasick, dizziness, vomiting. Bay of Bengal. Heavy rains, more sickness. I have no appetite.
So, Swamiji, how is your stay so far? We have been at sea for 10 days now. How is your sickness? Are you eating more solids? That will help you get your strength back.
Captain Pandya, thank you for asking. Today I feel better. Slowly I am recovering.
I have some good news for you, Swamiji.
Oh?
We have arrived in Cochin and your books from Bombay are here. As we speak, they have been loaded onto the ship.
Ah, that is wonderful news. These books are the basis on which I hope to attract the people of America to Lord Krishna.
Your agent Jairan and Sons have sent your car so you can look around Cochin. We will be docked here for one day, so it will be good for you to get out and about onto the mainland.
Yes, yes, Captain Pandya, I think this is a great idea. Yes, I will do it. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
I will instruct them to take you on tour. It is a very, very nice, clean city. The British used to live there.
Ah, thank you. Yes, yes, I will go now. 31st August, passed over a great crisis on the struggle for life and death. However, I had a dream that Krishna, he had taken charge of the boat, and the Lord was rowing the boat himself. He assured me not to fear, but to continue with the journey.
Swamiji, Swamiji.
Captain Pandya.
Is everything all right? I have not seen you for the next few days.
Captain Pandya, I am well, thank you. I am eating regularly now, so I am getting better. How long have we been at sea?
Well, today is Friday the 10th, 1965, which means we have been at sea for 29 days now. Very soon, we will arrive in America.
That is wonderful news, Captain. America.
Swamiji, the journey is the easy part. I have been here to help you. But once you leave us, you will be all alone with only 1 month visa to stay. Where will you go after that? Will you return to India?
Captain G, I am leaving it all in the hands of Lord Krishna. Whatever he desires, that I will do.
I must take your leave now.
Thank you, Captain Pandya. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Friday, September 10th. Today is the 32nd day of the journey. Today the ship is flying smoothly. I feel today better. But I am feeling separation from Sri Vrindavan and my Lord Govinda, Gopinath, Radha Damodar. The only solace is Chaitanya Charitamrita. I have left Bharata Bhumi just to execute the orders of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati in pursuance of Lord Chaitanya's order. I have no qualification, but have taken up the risk just to carry out the order of His divine grace. I depend fully on their mercy, so far from Sri Vrindavan Dham. Although my Guru Maharaj ordered me to accomplish this mission, I am not worthy or fit to do it. I am fallen and insignificant. Therefore, O Lord, now I am begging for your mercy so that I may become worthy. Except for you, there is no means of success.
Swamiji. Swamiji.
Captain Pandya.
After a long journey and having been on the boat for 38 days, we have finally arrived in America. We are approaching Boston Harbor.
Thank you, Captain Pandya. So we are here. I can begin my mission.
Swamiji, I have to say, in all my years of experience at the sea, I have never had such a smooth crossing of the Atlantic. She has not shown her usual face.
That is because Lord Krishna, he has taken charge of the ship.
Actually, that is exactly what my wife said. Swamiji, she has asked you to come on the return journey with us.
She is very intelligent and learned lady, Captain.
She said, if you have the goodwill of Krishna on your side, then you will success in your great mission.
Captain Pandya ji, thank you for your blessings and thank you for looking after me.
Swamiji, it was a great honor to have you on my ship. It is something I will never forget. But still, I worry about you in America. No money, nowhere to stay. The food is all meat there. America is such a dangerous and violent place for a foreigner. You know nothing of Devris. Seems a very impossible task ahead of you. Why are you risking your life?
Because there is a great need to tell the people about Krishna. The people, they are suffering. And only this message will help them. Captain Pandya, my mission will happen only if Krishna wants, not by my own endeavors.
Having read in your books on this trip, they are wonderful. Such a profound spiritual book. In the future, I am sure many, many people will read them.
Captain Pandya, that is my mission. To distribute these books. The people, they are eager to receive these books. That is my mission.
Well, I wish you well on your stay. Now, I have to make preparation for docking.
Captain Pandya, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Thank you, thank you.
Hare Krishna, Swamiji.
September 18, 1965. My dear Lord Krishna, you are so kind upon this useless soul, but I do not know why you have brought me here. Now you can do whatever you like with me. How will I make them understand this message of Krishna consciousness? Therefore, I am seeking your benediction so that I can convince them. I am powerless to do so on my own. O Lord, I am just like a puppet in your hands. So if you have brought me here to dance, then make me dance. Make me dance. Make me dance as you like. I have no devotion, nor do I have any knowledge. But I have strong faith in the holy name of Krishna. I have been designated as Bhaktivedanta. And now, if you like, you can fulfill the real purport of Bhaktivedanta. Signed, the most unfortunate, insignificant beggar, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami. On board the ship,
Jaladuta. Thank you.
Then Srila Prabhupada stepped onto American soil. After going through immigration, he didn't know whether to turn left or right. He stayed in Butler, Pennsylvania for 1 month, sponsored by Gopal Agarwal and his wife, Sally. There he had first-hand experience of how Westerners would receive the teachings of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He could tell the ground was fertile. Encouraged, he then moved to New York to start his preaching work. Dr. Mishra had welcomed Srila Prabhupada to stay with him in uptown Manhattan.
Today, we are very fortunate to have Swamiji here in my ashram. He will lead us into this chanting. I know you very much like this chanting he does. He's a great scholar and a devotee of Lord Krishna. Swamiji, do you know some of my students? They like you better than me.
Dr. Mishra, it is kind of you to host me here.
No. I am very grateful to you, Swamiji, for saving my life. My health was not very good. I was going to die, but you cooked for me daily. You restored my health. I am fit again.
Eating the right food is important for your health.
So how is your facility?
It is fine. But I feel I am restricted and cannot preach properly. You should assist me.
I have to decline. You see, I have my own things I want to achieve here in America. But thank you for your offer. Anyway, I have to go. Thank you for that beautiful chanting, Swamiji. Namaste.
Hare Krishna.
I really enjoyed your chanting, Swamiji. It is so different to what Dr. Mishra teaches. I just can't grasp the Hatha Yoga process. I find it so difficult.
It is indeed hard. That is why Bhakti Yoga is recommended for this age. It is an easier process for these times. I can teach you more if you want.
That would be really great. I have lots of friends who are also interested in Eastern spiritual wisdom.
That is good. But here I am restricted what I can say.
My friend Bill works in a restaurant. It's called Paradox. We like to discuss spiritual things there. I think it would be great if you went. They would love you, Swamiji. The word is already out, and they are eager to meet you. The guys there are younger. I'm more into genuine spiritual life.
Yes, good. I am not happy where I am staying. My belongings, they were stolen from my room. I'm staying in fear that it will happen again.
Oh, that's terrible, Swamiji. I have a loft. I'm renting it out to a friend. His name is David. It's in the Bowery. It is very basic, but there's plenty of space, and you can have your own chanting there and say whatever you want.
That sounds like an excellent idea. So, you can arrange that?
Sure I can. When it's arranged, I can pick you up and take you there.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Harvey.
My pleasure, Swamiji. The guys are really going to dig you.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
This way, Swamiji. It is very simple. It's not the best of neighborhoods. But at least you can have your own space to tell everyone about Krishna. Oh, this is David, who will be staying with you.
Whatever Krishna gives, I will be happy.
Some of my other friends are here too, Swamiji. They want to hear all about the chanting.
Yes, yes, bring them. Hare Krishna. Welcome. It is very nice of you to come and visit me here. I will hold regular meetings here. You are all invited, and please tell your friends as well to come. Now please, all of you, sit down. Invite the whole neighborhood. Well, goodbye for now, Swamiji. Thank you, Harvey, for arranging this place for me.
You're welcome. I think we will all greatly benefit from your stay here, Swamiji.
Srila Prabhupada settles in the Bowery, despite the drunks and the tramps who hung around the area. Yet Prabhupada showed respect to everyone, and he was now free to preach the pure teachings of Krishna to the people of America. Young progressive Americans were keen on his teachings and took to his chanting.
This Krishna consciousness is our prime goal in life. When we attain this rare human form of life, when we take to the service of serving Krishna and chanting Krishna's holy name, we become Krishna conscious. Ah, David, good you are here. I wanted to speak to you.
About what?
I have mentioned to you before not to leave the soap on the floor in the shower room.
Why? What's the problem?
It could be dangerous.
Dangerous? Oh, come on. How can soap be dangerous?
Because I can slip on it.
Whatever.
Can you please be more careful?
All right, all right. You know, I am getting sick and tired of you telling me what to do. Just get off my case, man. Get off my back and leave me alone.
The sound vibration of the Maha Mantra is transcendental. So by chanting, we come in contact with Krishna.
No!
David, are you all right? What is the matter, my boy? I want to help you, David. David, are you all right?
What's going on? No! Get away! Oh, my head! Who the hell are you? Leave me! No! No! Help!
No! No!
Hello. Carl Sagan, is this you?
Thank you.
I need your help. Well, David seems to be acting like crazy man, shouting and screaming at me. He is angry, very angry. He seems possessed. I don't feel safe with him. He is taking too many drugs. Please help me. I have left all my things in the loft. You will help me? Ah, that is very kind of you. I will wait outside for you. Thank you. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
With nowhere to go, Srila Prabhupada moved in with one of his admirers. But staying there was very inconvenient for the couple who took him in. With the help of some of his friends, they found a storefront for him to stay and do his work. Srila Prabhupada began his usual classes, and some were beginning to take Krishna consciousness seriously.
Here we are, Swamiji. This is the place we've rented for you, 26 Second Avenue. What do you think, Swamiji? It used to be some shop. We've all chipped in to pay for the first month's rent, and your living quarters will be behind the store. If you need something, please let us know.
Ah, look at the sign. Matchless gifts. This is very appropriate. This will do fine. It will be our first temple.
Temple? Swamiji?
Yes, temple. This is only the beginning. We will open many more around the world.
All around the world?
Yes.
Okay. Wow. Groovy.
We'll spread the word around about your meetings and chanting on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays. Your teachers are taking off, man. The whole experience, yeah, it's kind of mystical. And I love the food.
Thank you.
The conclusion of Krishna's words in the Bhagavad Gita is to perform bhakti, loving devotion to Him. It is our natural constitutional position to do everything for Krishna. Just see, He has begun His devotional service. That is the process. Whatever we have to give to Krishna. Now, Mr. Goldsmith is here today. It is very important day for us. Would you like to say something?
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. Good evening. I have been asked by Bhaktivedanta Swami to register his new movement. In order to do that, I need some signatures for the incorporation papers.
Mr. Howard, please sign. Mr. Roy. Yes, yes. Mr. Don, please sign. Mr. Grant, please, you sign as well.
Oh, Swamiji, we haven't discussed what we shall call your new society.
We shall call it the International Society for Krishna Consciousness, ISKCON.
Just a suggestion, Swamiji. Wouldn't it be better to call it God Consciousness? God is a word Westerners can relate to more. Krishna, well, no one really knows that name.
No. Krishna Consciousness. God has a name. So we should use it. The word God is too vague. If Westerners don't know who Krishna is, then the International Society for Krishna Consciousness will tell them by spreading His name in every town and village. Howard, can you please read the document under the part about our purposes?
Sure. 1. To systematically propagate spiritual knowledge to society at large and to educate all people in the techniques of spiritual life in order to check the imbalance of values in life and to achieve real unity and peace in the world. 2. To propagate a consciousness of Krishna, God, as it is revealed in the great scriptures of India, Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam. 3. To bring the members of the society together with each other and nearer to Krishna, the prime entity, thus developing the idea within the members and humanity at large that each soul is part and parcel of the quality of Godhead, Krishna. 4. To teach and encourage the Sankirtan movement, congregational chanting of the holy name of God, as revealed in the teachings of Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. 5. To erect for the members and for society at large a holy place of transcendental pastimes dedicated to the personality of Krishna. 6. To bring the members closer together for the purpose of teaching a simpler, more natural way of life. And 7. With a view towards achieving the aforementioned purposes, to publish and distribute periodicals, magazines, books, and other writings.
Yes, very good. All of you boys and girls will help me. Hare Krishna.
Swamiji, can we go chanting outside now? I like that very much.
Yes, it is Lord Chaitanya Sankirtan movement. Let us all now go to Tompkins Square Park to chant the holy name of Krishna. Everyone, thank you very much. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Let's have one final, very, very big round of applause, of appreciation for the great Bhaktivedanta.